To turn the pump on, again, hold your indicating arrows together to get to your option mode. And this time we're going to select the intermittent VPT. Use your cursor to get down to intermittent. Press your OK button. And there are four steps. When we did continuous, we only had one step, and that was to select the pressure. But in an intermittent mode, we have four steps. We have a high pressure, which currently is set at 80. And again, you can toggle in increments of 5 to the prescribed pressure setting. So we have negative 80. In the bottom, it says press OK. Now the arrow indicates a lower pressure. What do we want therapy to vacuum at the lower pressure? Again, in increments of 5, we can go down to negative 40. We press OK. The third and fourth step concern the time. How long do we want the pump to vacuum at the higher pressure and the lower pressure? You'll notice the small arrows indicate the upper time and the lower time. So we can go, just for sake of demonstration, we'll go to 0.5 minutes, which is 30 seconds. The timing goes from 30 seconds to 10 minutes. Press the OK button. Now you see the down arrow indicating what time do you want the pump to vacuum on the lower pressure. Press the OK button. The confirmation screen for intermittent VPT has said that we have selected negative 80 for 30 seconds and negative 40 for 30 seconds. Press the OK button and your therapy is being administered. On the left-hand side of the display screen, you'll notice an indicator bar. This references the dressing. It helps the clinician understand the looseness or tightness of their dressing application. As long as the black bar falls somewhere within the bar graft, you know that you have an adequate dressing seal. If the black bar goes out of the indicator, the alarm will sound. You'll notice the horizontal bar at the top will appear in the display screen after a couple minutes. This is the timing bar that helps you understand where you are in the sequence of variable pressure. Currently, we have it set for 30 seconds, just for the sake of demonstration, to allow us to see the timing bar going back and forth with each cycle. Now you notice the bar is beginning to go back the other direction. So basically for 30 seconds, the pump vacuumed at negative 80. The timing bar was recognized, and now the pump is vacuuming at negative 40.